Hey there, I'm Bergen, and welcome back to the Plytix Academy. In this lesson, we're going to talk about digital assets. First, we'll look at what an asset is and how it relates to PIM. Then we'll take a quick look at the magic of storing digital assets as URLs. Next, we'll talk about the importance of asset naming conventions before we take a closer look at two ways of importing assets into a PIM platform. Finally, we'll cover why you should link your assets to your products so that you can easily rename and resize your files. What is a digital asset? Well, it's pretty simple. A digital asset is any file or content related to your products that is stored digitally. An example of digital assets could be anything from graphics to photos or videos, or even files like PDFs, spreadsheets, slideshow presentations, and more. And just like product attributes, digital assets grow exponentially as digital content is created and shared. So, how do digital assets relate to product information? Jumping back to our t-shirt example, not only does a t-shirt have a lot of attributes like color, size, and price, but it'll also have a bunch of digital media connected to it, like pictures and videos of the t-shirt, or even files of the logos and graphics. Digital assets are basically all of the files needed in order to market and sell the t-shirt, especially when selling online. As I'm sure we all know, when it comes to digital files, especially images and videos, storage space can be a big issue. So, how do most companies store their digital assets? Probably the same way you do, on your computer, on external hard drives, or on cloud hosting services like Dropbox or Google Drive. Those are all adequate systems for file storage. But when it comes to optimizing your product data, it doesn't make much sense to keep your product information in one system like a PIM and your product assets somewhere else. That's why the best PIM platforms bring the two together under one digital roof. How does it work? Well, a solid PIM will have a fully functioning DAM, or digital asset management system, integrated into its platform so that all of your assets are stored in the same system as your product information, making files and information easy to find, optimize, and share. Now that you understand what a digital asset is and how you can store your digital assets alongside your product information, let's take a look at how this works. Typically, when you upload an asset to a PIM system, it will store that file on a server. In Plytix, once that file is saved, a unique and publicly accessible URL, like this one, is created. Each asset will need a unique URL, just as each product has a unique SKU. This makes connecting products to their assets simple. All you need to do is map the connection between the product SKU and the assets URL. And we'll talk about why that's important and how this works in Plytix a little later on in this lesson. Asset naming conventions. Okay, so we already know what an asset is and that we can store them directly into the PIM, but you're probably wanting to know how you can upload your assets into the platform. To start off, we recommend that you review your assets to make sure they follow a strong naming convention. And if they don't, we've got a few tips to help you get started. Why use a naming convention? Well, it'll help you understand what kind of information the file contains just by looking at its name. And believe me, this will save you a lot of time and probably a few headaches too. Going back to the t-shirt example, say you start with a JPEG image. The camera might name this file something like this, but that's not very helpful for us. So let's take a look at a few examples of how we might rename this file. The first example, white space t-shirt.jpg, isn't a very good name for an asset because it tells us very little about the product in the image. Plus, we have no idea how many versions of this asset there are. Can you imagine searching for a specific image angle or detail and all you have to go off of is white t-shirt? You'll never find what you're looking for. Plus, that file name uses a space in the title, which could cause problems down the line. The second example with an underscore number is a bit better. We can see that there's no spaces in the title, which will ensure that files can pass through multiple systems without errors. And the number tells us that we've got even more than one picture of our white t-shirt, but we can do even better. Example 3 is best because it uses the product SKU. This will help us match the product to the assets after we've uploaded. The name also tells us about the image, so we know that it's a close-up of my white t-shirt and that there are multiple versions of this image. In this example, the underscore helps us distinguish between the different elements and functions as an element separator, while the dash is used to replace a space. Using a strong naming convention will save you time when it comes to organizing and linking your assets and SKUs. And it'll help you search and filter through your asset catalog. Importing your assets. Once you've got your naming convention in place and implemented, it's time to import or upload your digital assets into the PIM. Depending on your PIM system, there will be different ways to do this. So I'll walk you through two common methods, via a data fetch or a data drop. Fetching assets is the easiest and fastest option to get your digital media into your PIM, because all you're doing is moving files from one hosting service to another. In practice, this usually means taking files stored as a URL and reassigning them a new URL, like the Plytix one we looked at earlier. That also means that once the data fetch is complete, your assets are now stored in your PIM and can be deleted from your previous system. Your second option for uploading assets into a PIM platform is via data drop. Data drops take more time than fetching because you'll be uploading original files instead of transferring data from one system to another. But the process itself is simple. Simply drag and drop files and folders that will be uploaded to your PIM servers. Asset and product mapping. Once your assets are in your PIM platform, you should sync your files to your products. And depending on your PIM system, this process will look different. And this is when your file naming convention comes in handy. If your file names already contain the SKU of the product it references, you should be able to easily identify and sync products to assets in bulk. Keep in mind that it's not necessary to link every single asset to a product, but if you do, it opens the door to some pretty cool PIM tricks that'll help you work with your products faster and smarter. Renaming and resizing assets. When it comes to selling online, one size does not fit all, meaning that even if you plan to sell the exact same product on two different marketplaces like Amazon or Wayfair, it's likely that those marketplaces will have their own requirements regarding the file sizes they will accept and how those files should be named. Now, this might sound a little abstract, so let's take a closer look at renaming and resizing digital assets. Looking again at this image of our trusty t-shirt, if we plan to include this t-shirt in a printed catalog, we'll need a high resolution file so that the image is crisp and shows detail. However, if we want to use the same image on our Shopify store, we need to use a much smaller resolution of that same file because we want our Shopify page to load quickly. In the days before PIM, we would need to manually resize and save different versions of the exact same photo, taking up valuable time and storage space. With the PIM system, you'll store the largest resolution of your digital files and then use tools within the PIM so that you can resize those images when exporting into different channels. And this works for file names as well. Earlier in this lesson, we talked about the importance of internal naming conventions for your files. But when it comes to sharing them on certain websites, you'll want to adapt file names so that they are search engine friendly. In the old days, this would mean saving two versions of the exact same file. But with a PIM, you can simply convert an internal file name to an SEO title upon export. All right, that's it for lesson three. Now let's look back at what we've learned before your quiz. In this lesson, we've discovered that digital assets are any type of digital content like images, videos, PDFs, and graphics. We also learned that digital assets are connected to unique URLs, just like products are connected to SKUs. Next, we talked about how to create strong naming conventions for assets so that you can find your files quickly. And we covered how to upload your assets to your PIM via data drop or data fetch. Finally, we discussed the importance of linking your assets to your products so that you can easily rename and resize them without duplicating any files. So now it's time for your quiz. Good luck, and we'll see you in your next lesson on your single source of truth.